नमस्कार दोस्तों, मैं एडवोकेट राजन कुमार, साथ हमारे हैं निशा जी। आज हम आपके सामने फिर आए हैं, आज एक नया टॉपिक लेकर आए हैं, भारतीय कानून व्यवस्था या भारतीय कानून प्रणाली। हमारे देश का कानून किस तरह से काम करता है और इसकी प्रणाली यानी इसके चलाने के तरीके क्या हैं, तो इसके बारे में हम आज डिटेल में डिस्कस करेंगे और स्लाइड के थ्रू मैं बताऊंगा। स्लाइड में आवाज निशा जी की रहेगी। इस वीडियो में हमने सिर्फ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज का यूज किया है, जिससे कि जो लीगल प्रोफेशन में है वो इस चीज को पूरी तरह से समझ सके और गेन कर सके।
और मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी कि हमारे जितने भी वीडियोस आप तक पहुंच रहे हैं, आप उनको लाइक करें और ज्यादा से ज्यादा शेयर करें, और साथ में हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल वाले आइकन को प्रेस करें।
पूरी वीडियो को देखें, जिससे कि जानकारी आपको पूरी मिल सके और पूरी तरीके से अच्छे तरह से उसको समझ सके। आइए चलते हैं स्लाइड्स की तरफ। धन्यवाद, नमस्कार।
इंडियन लीगल सिस्टम एंड इंट्रोडक्शन बाय आर के प्रसाद एंड मिस निशा, एडवोकेट्स लॉ मास्टर्स। इंडियन लीगल सिस्टम। इंडियन लॉ रेफर्स टू द सिस्टम ऑफ लॉ विच ऑपरेट्स इन इंडिया। इट इज लार्जली बेस्ड ऑन इंग्लिश कॉमन लॉ। वेरियस एक्ट्स इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द ब्रिटिश आर स्टिल इन इफेक्ट इन मॉडिफाइड फॉर्म टूडे। Much of contemporary Indian law shows substantial European and American influence. History of Indian law. Ancient India represented a distinct tradition of law. India had an historical independent school of legal theory and practice. The Arthashastra dated from 400 BC and the Manusmriti from 100 AD were influential treatises in India. Manu's central philosophy was tolerance and pluralism and was cited across Southeast Asia. Source of law. Primary source. The primary source of law is in the enactments passed by the parliament or the state legislatures. The president and the governor have limited powers to issue ordinances. These ordinances lapse 6 weeks from the reassembly of the parliament or the state legislature. Source of law. Secondary source. Secondary source of law is the judgments of the Supreme Court, High Courts, and some of the specialized tribunals. The Constitution provides that the law declared by the Supreme Court shall be binding on all courts within India. Constitution of India. The Constitution declares India to be a sovereign, socialist, democratic republic, assuring its citizens of justice, equality, and liberty. It is the longest written constitution of any independent nation in the world. It contains 395 articles and 12 schedules as well as numerous amendments for a total of 117,369 words in the English language version. Preamble of the Constitution. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. Fundamental rights. Equality before the law. Freedom from discrimination on grounds of religion, race, caste, sex or place of birth. Equality of opportunity in matters of public employment. Freedom of speech and expression. Right to assembly peacefully without arms. Protection against deprivation of life and personal liberty. Freedom of conscience and the profession, practice and propagation of religion. To move freely through India, to reside or settle in any part of India. Fundamental duties added to the Constitution in 1977 to abide by the Constitution, respect its ideals and institutions, the national flag and the national anthem, to value and preserve the rich heritage of our composite culture, to protect and improve the national environment including forests, lakes, rivers and wildlife, to have compassion for living creations, to strive towards excellence in all spheres of individual and collective activity. Criminal law. Indian Penal Code provides a penal code for all of India, including Jammu and Kashmir, where it was renamed the Ranbir Penal Code, RPC. The code applies to any offense committed by an Indian citizen anywhere and on an Indian registered ship or aircraft. Indian Penal Code came into force in 1862 during the British Raj and is regularly amended, such as to include Section 498A. Civil Procedure Code. The Civil Procedure Code regulates the functioning of civil courts. It lays down the procedure of filing the civil case, powers of court to pass various orders, court fees and stamps involved in filing of case, rights of the parties to case, plaintiff and defendant, jurisdiction and parameters of civil courts functioning, specific rules for proceedings of a case, right of appeals, review or reference. Family law. Indian civil law is complex, with each religion having its own specific laws which they adhere to. After independence, Indian laws have adapted to the changing world, the most recent being the Domestic Violence Act 2005. Industrial and labor laws. The most notable laws are as follows: Industrial Dispute Act 1947, Wages Act 1948, Employers State Insurance Act 1948, Employers Provident Fund and Miscellaneous Provisions Act 1952, Bidi and Cigar Workers Act 1974, Equal Remuneration Act 1976, Contract Labor Act 1970, Child Labor Act 1986, Bonded Labor System Act 1976. The Employees Provident Funds Act 1952. The Act shall apply to every establishment which is a factory engaged in any industry mentioned in Schedule 1st of the Act and employing 20 or more persons, or any other establishment employing 20 or more persons, or such other establishment as the central government may notify. Right to Information Act 2003. The right to information emerges out of the umbrella of right to freedom of speech and expression and right to life. Right to information is also the centrifugal point for access to my right, other basic human rights such as environment, health, food, livelihood, etc. The most direct transformation that the right to information effects is in the governance system. From the perspective of citizenship, right to information is the primary tool in the hands of the citizen. Writs. The writs are issued by the Supreme Court under Article 32 and by the High Courts under Article 226 of the Constitution of India. Types of writs: writ of prohibition, writ of habeas corpus, writ of certiorari, writ of mandamus, writ of quo warranto. Indian judicial system. The three-tiered system of Indian judiciary comprises of Supreme Court, New Delhi, at its helm. High courts standing at the head of state judicial system, followed by district and sessions courts in the judicial districts into which the states are divided. The lower rung of the system then comprises of courts of civil judges and criminal judicial metropolitan magistrate jurisdiction. The Supreme Court. On the 28th of January 1950, the Supreme Court came into being. The judges of the Supreme Court at the time of inauguration were Chief Justice Harilal J. Kania and Justices Syed Faisal Ali, M. Patanjali Shastri, Mehr Chand Mahajan, Vijan Kumar Mukherjee and S. R. Das. The first Attorney General for India was Mr. M. C. Sitalt. The Supreme Court. The Supreme Court of India comprises the Chief Justice and not more than 25-30 other judges appointed by the President of India. The proceedings of the Supreme Court are conducted in English only. The registry of the Supreme Court is headed by the Registrar General. The Attorney General for India is appointed by the President of India under Article 76 of the Constitution. Three types of advocates: senior advocates, advocates on record, and other advocates. The High Courts. The High Courts are generally the last court of regular appeal. Besides for invoking writ jurisdiction, the High Courts can be approached for enforcement of other rights. It has the power to supervise the subordinate courts falling within its territorial jurisdiction. The High Courts are courts of record. The High Courts also exercises original jurisdiction under the Companies Act. The High Courts. The High Court hears first appeals from the decision of the district courts. Section 100 of the Code of Civil Procedure provides for a second appeal from appellate decrees. Under Section 115 of the Code, the High Court is conferred with revisional jurisdiction. Under Article 227 of the Constitution also, the High Court, in the exercise of its power of superintendence, entertains revision petitions to correct errors on the part of lower courts and tribunals in judicial and quasi-judicial matters. The High Courts. On the criminal side, the High Court has to confirm all sentences of death passed by courts of session and hear references in this behalf. High Court hears criminal appeals from convictions awarded by session judges and additional session judges, or form the judgment of any other court where a sentence for more than 7 years imprisonment has been passed. The High Court is also empowered to entertain appeals from orders of acquittal passed by any court. High Court has also been conferred with criminal revisional jurisdiction. The subordinate courts. These subordinate courts are district courts empowered to hear appeals from courts of original civil jurisdiction besides having original civil jurisdiction. Sessions Court is courts of criminal jurisdiction having the similar scope of powers. The courts of specific original jurisdiction are courts of civil judges, of judicial magistrates, small causes courts, and courts of metropolitan magistrates. Quasi-judicial system. This appendage to the Indian judicial system is a recent and sincere attempt on the part of the government to expedite the judicial process through dilution of procedural formalities and avoidance of litigation. Tribunals form an indispensable part of the system, which are appointed by the government and comprise of judges and experts on the particular field for which the tribunal has been constituted. Recent trends in law. Criminal Procedure Code. Plea bargaining in criminal cases. Plea bargaining is introduced in India by Criminal Law Amendment Act 2005. This affects cases in which the maximum punishment is imprisonment for 7 years. However, offences affecting the socio-economic condition of the country and offences committed against a woman or a child below the age of 14 are excluded. Recent trends in law. Civil Procedure Code 1908. Mediation and conciliation encouraged. Number of adjournments, services of summons by other means, evidence by way of affidavits, time limit to pronounce judgments. New trends in judiciary. Computerization of courts. Scope of PIL is being limited. Judiciary has become more open. Concept of justice at doorstep encouraged. Lok Adalats, special courts to dispose of petty cases. Evening courts started in many states. Legal education. At present, there are two educational options for would-be law graduates in India. One is a 5-year program to which one can be admitted after passing a school leaving examination taken after completion of 10+2. The other is a 3-year program available only to those who have already graduated with a degree in arts, science or commerce. Are you aware that about 2/3 of our laws have not been used in independent India? About 10% of them can be scrapped right away. And most of the 10% in use currently have so many obsolete and conflicting provisions. The oldest law in the country has been operation for over a century and a half. The one sentence 1836 Bengal District Act empowers the Bengal government to create as many zillas as it wants. The act still exists. Under the Indian Sarais Act 1867, it is a punishable offence for innkeepers not to offer free drinking water to passers-by. Only about 40% of our laws are in regular use. Independent India has still now found no conceivable use for the rest. While India badly needs efficient laws, the time spent by the law-making body on the job is unbelievably little. Parliament spends less than 0.6% of a Lok Sabha day on law-making. Thanks for watching YouTube video. Please write your valuable comments. We request you to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for getting relevant updates. Good night.